So my name is Jamie Skella and I'm the co-founder of Horizon State. Ultimately, we exist to answer one question, and that's what would democracy have looked like if it was designed with the modern technology we have available to us today? So the ways that we're governing ourselves at the moment is effectively a relic of the last 100 years, if not more. We live in a world where driverless cars are on the verge of possibility, and in fact they already are, despite not being as sophisticated as they will be in a few years. And yet the democratic processes and tools we employ to coordinate ourselves and to collectively make decisions amongst ourselves are the equivalent of a horse and cart. The reference I made in the article that I wrote in regards to the announcement of Horizon State is that, you know, we have in our pockets the computational power to send people to the moon, but our electoral system is the equivalent of a pocket calculator. And so it's really about time. It has been far too long in the making, and despite the advent of the internet, there has always been legitimate concerns about the security of and access to those votes. But the internet and access to it has matured, and thanks to blockchain, we are able to solve some really complex security puzzles in ultimately what are kind of simple ways. So there's no excuse anymore. We have the opportunity for constituents of any kind of community, be it a nation or a company, to be able to represent their opinion, be delivered the right information, deliberate on that information, and ultimately submit a vote that is secure, a vote that cannot be tampered with, a vote that can be recounted in perpetuity with transparency by the entire constituency. So using Australia's same-sex marriage plebiscite as an example, the government is undertaking a postal vote, which is sent out to the eligible voters around the country, and it's doing so at a cost of around $122 million, which is a significant cost. If you look at the active voter population and the number of people that will likely send in their responses, it's in the vicinity of $6 to $8 per vote, which is significant. So if we look at alternatives, such as the technology that Horizon State has developed, blockchain-based, the transactions themselves are just cents in terms of complete sunk costs, which includes product development, iteration, support and sales. It's still significantly less, 10-15 times less. So the way I like to refer to the blockchain is that it's a record book. It just so happens that this record book is shared. It's shared across hundreds and indeed thousands of computers, and they all have to agree on the transactions that are being added to this ledger, to this record book. So in the context of Bitcoin, which is probably the most commonly and widely understood application for blockchain, you would transact a Bitcoin from Bob to Sue. And in the case of a distributed ledger, rather than just Sue recording this entry in her record book, there would be hundreds of friends and associates that stand around. They would make sure that they have seen the same transaction from the same place to the same place of the appropriate value, and then they would also fill in their record books accordingly. Now, if anybody disagrees, that's a bit of a problem. And so really what we're talking about is a consensus mechanism. It's a way for multiple parties, and in, you know, in relation to technology, multiple computers, to reach consensus on a certain transaction. For us, those transactions are votes. Which is, you know, not necessarily a groundbreaking idea in concept, but we happen to be the first people that have managed to implement it for the public to use and be used widely. In regards to the way that we're utilising blockchain technology for Horizon State, and indeed this voting platform, is effectively the creation of some new tokens, not entirely dissimilar to Bitcoin in that they are a crypto asset which can be transacted. But instead of being a transaction of value, it's effectively a vote. Now, by buying DCT tokens doesn't mean that you have bought votes that you can use. What it means is that you are a part of the ecosystem which will fuel the ability to create votes and cast them. So if a national government, or indeed some kind of multinational enterprise, wanted to use our technology, they would need these DCT tokens to fuel the commitment of those votes to a public blockchain and effectively pay what we call the gas for all of the computers on the network to verify those transactions. So in the same way that we talked about Bob and Sue having a network of friends stand around them to verify, it's the participation of that verification that is effectively being paid for with these decision tokens. Now, over time, the higher demand that we get, the higher potential price these tokens will have. There is a finite number of the tokens, and it's ultimately a matter of supply and demand. So if we happen to bring on a few national governments or a few multinational enterprises, that means significant things for success of the business, but also success of the people that believe in this vision. Beautifully and importantly, there are already governments and councils and independent politicians who are running for seats that have approached us about using this technology. So despite the fact that it seems like a relatively lengthy process, and it will be in many situations, what we found is that there is absolutely keen interest, particularly in developing nations and particularly with independents and smaller parties that are wanting to engage their constituency with immediacy, with transparency, and be able to represent that majority viewpoint.